Welcome to the KIM Consortium. This is April 24th, 2010, and we're analyzing the financial markets and the various news stories that come out on a variety of channels. We found ourselves making a comparison between classical art and classical accounting versus Jackson Pollock art and Jackson Pollock accounting. We found that analysts and investors in 2010 are forced to interpret financial statements, politicians, regulations, as if they were paintings like Jackson Pollock. The fact of the matter is, the financial markets in the past and paintings in the past were initially like Mona Lisa, which was thin layers of oil paint depicting classical art, which mimicked light and reality. You can look at the painting and know what it was. Over the times and over the ages, art began to depict more creative things. There was Impressionist art. There was abstract art. And then there was Jackson Pollock. Jackson Pollock splatters ink, splatters paint onto a canvas as he hangs from the ceiling. And he wants, in essence, the viewer to define what the painting is about. So Jackson Pollock demands the imagination of the viewer to define the reality of the painting. We dare to say that today's accounting, be it Reg 105 in Goldman Sachs or Tobashi, can be labeled as Jackson Pollock accounting. We've coined the phrase, ladies and gentlemen. Enjoy the poems. Enjoy the show.
A painting by Jobeth Posey Horton, entitled Cultural Diversity. Pure and simple, it's either black or white. If you knew me, you'd understand my plight. There really is no zero-sum game. Emotions and passion are to blame. Like a bubble, it all burst. Defining the issues made me cursed. An eruption was imminent, that was clear. Defining the moment was impossible, dear. Finally, it all was blood red. Couldn't calculate the variables in my head. Too many perspectives of right and wrong, driven by passion, oh so strong. I can't just be black and white. In the end, who knows who's wrong or right?